Hello and welcome to the Q&A session about Aruvi. We'd asked for some questions and we got quite a few. I'm going to pick a few of them and try to talk about the film. Dr. Arulasan J asks, why shouldn't Aruvi be categorized in the age-old temperament of the protagonist having a cancer or terminal illness kind of film? What makes it special? Well, I think it's a little different from saying that this is a film about the protagonist with an illness. It's because those tend to be melodramas, right? They bear, you know, you follow the course of the illness and things like that. Whereas here what happens is you're kind of the illness, if you want to call it that, becomes a springboard for a very different kind of movie, because that drives her to a reality show and then that makes a different kind of thing. So it's not just about, usually these movies about illnesses are about that particular person's, you know, trajectory through life, whereas here you get a bit of surrealism and all kinds of things which allows the film to make a commentary about the world at large. And I think that's why this film is different, rather than it just being another, you know, regular movie about an illness. Yogesh Chinnadurai asks, like movies like Aruvi and Joker are not taken to the national media, even if not remade or remade, the remake quality is not good. Why? Well, I think one of the reasons some films like these are not translated is because, you know, there may be stories that are particular to a region or work well here. They need not always translate better to another medium. Just like there are certain Hindi films that might not work well in Tamil. So I don't think it's that thing. And about why the movie is not made well, I think that's a case-by-case basis. That depends on the director. But I think generally, when a movie like Joker or Aruvi comes and in any language, I think we should just, you know, be very happy about it. Nityanandan asks, in reality, does a CRPF team really come when a group of 20 people's lives are threatened? I'm saying that's too much reality questioning for a movie like this, because the movie itself is not a very real movie. The movie is, you know, I'm not just talking about the surrealism of the studio things, but it's also taking off into a bit of a, like, it's not really reality. So I think the you know, just like the threat of the, it is more like to address the hostage situation that these people are brought in. I think it's a little more effective than when the regular cops come in. Plus, also don't forget that they assume that she's a Naxal. So that could also be a reason this is happening. Nityanandan again, the scene where Aruvi asks the studio mates to perform certain tasks, though humorous at certain moments, seem to dominate and irrelevant. What's your view on that? Actually, I didn't find that irrelevant at all, because in a way she's kind of, you know, the world, she's been kind of a passive recipient of the world's treatment towards her. And now she's taking this opportunity to kind of, you know, dispense some justice of her own. You know, she's kind of making people dance to her, you know, tune. And I think that's what this is about. I don't think it's a comedy element as such, but it's more like she finally has the control over what the narrative of her life is going to be. And I think that's what this moment is about, where she gets to kind of make the calls on who's doing what, rather than be like a passive recipient of all the actions. Adiyan Ramanujadasan asks, why are Hindu gods depicted like this? Creative freedom of Malays loaded to AK-47 levels, trying being secular here. I think he's talking about the poster of Aruvi, where you know, the protagonist is in a crown and she looks like a goddess with an AK-47. I don't think it should be taken as reality. I think it's just an impression of the kind of a visual treatment that kind of gets into a zone of the movie, where you kind of have these contrasting elements in place. I don't think it's really an insult on Hindu gods as such. Murali asked, do you think the comedy track in the film worked well for mass? Well, Murali, I think first of all, there is no comedy track as such in this film. I think the humor is integrated into a lot of the situations and dialogues and other things. There are comic situations, yes, but there's also underlying tragedy to all that, because of the situation the protagonist finds herself in. So I don't think the comedy track is the kind of comedy track that one puts in because, you know, it's going to do well in the B and C centers. It's not that kind of comedy track at all. I don't think that's necessarily going to be the selling point here. Murali also asks, and also, do you like the approach of mixing the comedy in a serious plot like Aruvi had. I think I just answered that question. Again, I don't think it's about mixing comedy in. I think the humor is kind of woven into that, and I think part of, you know, her situation is so ridiculous that she finds the other situations ridiculous. Nash says, in your opinion, based on your point of view, what was the main reason of Aruvi's action when she decided to be in the TV show? I think the reason, I had a little bit of doubt too when I saw the movie first, because I was like, why should she choose a TV show of all things to go do this? But I think two things happened here. One is, it's also like there's a question of her friend Emily is the one that leads her there first, and I think that and once she sees that and gets into that milieu is when she really begins to kind of thing. Otherwise, she was just only interested in taking on those three men and kind of bringing them to justice. But now I think, you know, that once that went out of the window, I think the rest of the things kind of fell into place about, you know, what she does, takes them hostage and things like that. So I think the reason is not one reason so much as her finding herself at that particular place at that particular time and then winging it when the situation came. Shafi asked, do you think Aruvi got the deserved ending and why do you think so? And then in a similar question, Gokul Log asks, why do you dislike the climax portion where Aruvi yearns for those people to meet her and spend her last moments with them? Isn't that a basic human reaction to one's life as such? See, I'll tell you. So the question to both is, I don't think Aruvi got the deserved ending, though I could certainly see why that ending felt good. The reason it did not work for me all that much is because the film till that point is very unsentimental, you know, and then suddenly at that point, it's like, it's almost like it's begging for our tears. And that kind of the transition from the tone, the tonality of the studio portions to the end was not very like clean for me. I think that was my main problem, rather than what she ends up doing. Krishna Kishore asks, which particular aspect of the film made you give this much of a positive review and applause for this film? I think I answered a bit of this earlier, because other without being what could have been just a movie about a girl with an illness or a disease, instead takes off and becomes a kind of film about that kind of addresses the world at large. It becomes a larger issue at place rather than just as one thing. And I think it's very unusual to find the setting like the reality show out there. And I think that's what really makes the movie, because suddenly the tables are turned and you find, because I don't think the reality show is actually being trolled, or I don't think the reality show is being spoofed. It's more that the whole aspect of who's judging and who's being judged and verdicts are being passed, that is what this kind of thing is about, you know. Whereas and in that she's also unmasking some of the hypocrisies of society. So I think all this kind of springs from that illness rather than it just being about her treatment or something like that, you know. The movie is about this one person and it slowly brings in the world at large, and I think that's what's really impressive for me. Praveen is asking, what is your most liked thing in this movie? And that's the same thing. And finally, Nitin Singhania says, amazing concept at Film Companion. So grateful for all the soul-quenching work that you people are thinking of and implementing. Not sure if you're getting the deserving response and feedback, but thank you so much. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Thank you so much for that amazing tweet and comment. And I think we will keep trying to do things that are hopefully new and interesting. And please keep writing in when next week we come out with this question again. And we hope, that this grows into a regular feature of Film Companion. Thank you for watching.
Hi, this is Baradwaj Rangan. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more, do subscribe to Film Companion South.